In this video, we talk about Spring Framework implementation of the Inversion of Control, or IOC principle. IOC is also known as Dependency Injection, DI, the process of providing the dependencies. There are several other techniques to implement IOC, such as factory pattern, service locator pattern, etc. In this example, we use Spring Context Library, which provides call functionality. You can add Maven dependency or download jar file to import the project build path. To create the Spring bin, you simply code the POJO and configure bin element to the Spring XML configuration file or annotating the POJO. In this example, XML-based configuration file is used to do it. I use Spring Tools with Wizard to generate the Spring bin configuration file. The SDL is an Eclipse-based development environment that is customized for developing Spring applications. It provides a ready-to-use environment to implement, debug, run, and deploy your Spring applications, including the integrations. A Spring bin in the Ioc container can be any POJO. In this example, we create a simple Java bin, hello bin, with two properties, name and message, and of course with the accessor methods. Dependency injection is the process to define objects' dependencies. The IOC container then injects those dependencies when it instantiates the bin. This process is fundamentally the inverse. A STEAD plugin also supports widgets to configure Spring bin, but in my point of view, I prefer to do it manually as a clip support content proposal or intelligent feature. You can activate by pressing Ctrl Space combination. Every bin has one or more identifiers. These identifiers must be unique within the container that hosts the bin. ID and .name attributes to specify the bin identifiers. Code is cleaner with the dependency injection principle, and decoupling is more effective when objects are provided with their dependencies. The object does not look up for its dependencies and does not know the location or class of the dependencies. Dependency injection exists in two major variants, constructor dependency injection and setter dependency injection. Now we create the Java class for testing purpose. The IOC container at the core of the Spring framework is manages Java object from instantiation to destruction through bin factory. The bin factory is the lowest level implementation of the IOC container, but it is recommended to use application context for your application. Application context is derived from the bin factory to provide added functionality to work with web application. There are a few different ways to implement application context. In this example, we'll use class path XML application context, which is a very popular one. You should follow standard convention when naming bins. Bins names start with a lowercase letter and camelcase from then on. Naming bins consistently makes configuration easier to read and understand. In this example, the test class is standard Java application with the main method. The first line of the main method creates an instance of class pass XML application context, passing the part of Spring bin configuration file to its constructor, which is assigned to the application context interface. The application context get bin method due in the next line to retrieve the bin instance from the IOC container. Spring can be used in a standard application, web application, full Java EE application. The only requirement is that the application must run in standard Java virtual machine. The fact that setter injection was used in Spring itself and frameworks like Spring in general are much more suited to be configured by setter injection than by constructor injection. This is mostly because frameworks that need to be configured often contain lots of optional value. Now we move to another type injection, constructor injection. Any class that has constructor that takes argument can obviously not be constructed without passing in arguments. In Java, we have default or implicit constructor added to the class as long as you do not add one without any arguments. It will be possible for Spring to instantiate the class without passing it anything. We use constructor injection for all mandatory collaborators and setter injection for all other properties. In other words, constructor injection ensures all mandatory properties have been certified. Constructor injection is accomplished by the container invoking a constructor with a number of arguments, each representing a dependency. Calling a static factory method with specific arguments to construct the bin is nearly equivalent. The configuration of the bin is exactly the same, but we have a new element. The constructor argument element injects a message into the bin using value attribute. A ref element is the final element inside constructor argument or property definition element. Here you set the value of specified property of the bin to a reference to another bin, a collaborator, managed by the container. The reference bin is a dependency of the bin whose property will be set, and it initializes on demand as needed before the property is set. If the collaborator's singleton bin is maybe initialized already by the container, all references are ultimately a reference to another object. Scoping or validation depend on whether you specify ID or name of the other object through the bin, local or parent attributes. Specifying the target bin through the bin attribute of the ref tag is the most general form and allow creation of the reference to the bin in the same container or parent container, regardless whether it's in the same XML file. The value of the bin attribute may be same as in ID attribute of the target bin, or as one of the values in the name attribute of the target bin.